Maybe in the Bamber Tech they would try to mix things up, but TP, you're worried because you said you think this is actually probably Optic's best hardpoint.
It really has to be, especially since Krim has switched recently to that primary second SMG role for them. So much aggression for him on this map. He's gotten a lot more comfortable with it, and we see Skump sort of take that secondary role in terms of slaying. It's kind of weird to see.
All right, well, here we go. Off the rip, Skump getting right in, looking for kills, able to pick up an assist, and now being contested, not finding any more, but three go down. Formal shutting down everything. He kills the entire team. There's five before dropping. We'll go ahead and stick with him through the respawn as he filled up the entire kill feed.
Outside of that streak, though, Elevate does a good job getting into the hardpoint, mixing it up. Now they're going to have to figure out a way, though, to get Formal off his game. He's going with the Man of War in this one, Teep, and the Man of War, a very good assault rifle on this map, because this map's a little, close to medium range engagements.
Definitely, you're going to see Formal at these top power spots over and over again with this Man of War, looking over the rest of his teammates as they flood. They're one of the best teams at doing it. There's a reason why this is one of their best hardpoint maps.
All right, well, here we go. 10 seconds left as we begin to rotate out to the next hardpoint. No one really able to get an edge there, center map. Now it's on Aqua, looking to find some kills. He sees teammates dropping around him. He's going to push the back helipad, see if he can find some. That should start to control the spawns. And those are two big kills to start locking things down. And as I start to highlight your great play,
you jump off.
That's absolutely huge, though, but he is lucky enough to spawn in. But we see Felony spawn out across the way on the minimap. Need to look out, though. Good kills in from Facento to try and lock down this hill, but good job from Optic making sure you get that back helipad spawn. Aqua made the play to get the back, but falling off the map was crucial to them losing control of the hardpoint.
And if you're Elevate, you kind of give this one more go at this hardpoint, and then you start setting up for the third. And I think the one thing they did wrong in the first series against Optic is that they, once the game started to get fast, they kept it at that pace. They didn't try and, rotate, set up, and slow them down. And if you're going to get in a shooting match with Optic, well, you're going to lose most of the time. And see Facento, he's going to try and take the last 10 or so seconds here, but this is where the big get battle is going to go down. It's going to be Felony trying to lock down this position for his team. He's going to drop, and Karma is the man for Optic that is always controlling these big power positions.
He always has had someone with him, too, on that rotation. That gunfight is huge. It allows them to get this first 10 to 15 intro second time. A camo going down at the front of the hill as well, but Karma always seems to be that player on the rotation making these huge plays, and that's why Optic's able to extend their lead.
Well, everybody basically dropping outside of Formal, but they have the spawns in the back. He tries to push forward, can't hold on. There might be a pinch here because a bit of a split spawn coming due to the aggression from Elevate. Kid Karma now open things up with Krim. They're starting to fly in. They've started to see a little bit of a deficit. I mean, no one's been able to pull away at this point. I know it's been super, super back and forth, but does anyone have the edge for you? Teams have kept it close with Optic up to 100.
Well, so for me, one interesting thing is we've been talking all weekend about how good Karma's been with the assault rifle in his hands, and him and Krim have switched. And in this one, we see Karma with the SMG not getting off to that hot start. You're not seeing Krim get off to a great start either. Elevate needs to capitalize on this. They need to build a lead because I feel like Optic's going to change things up halfway through the game, and then they're going to start to gain some momentum.
Well, TB, I'm curious from your perspective. It seems like it gets close, right? It's usually in that 80 to 100 point game. They're very, very tight with their opponents, and then they start to get control, erupt, take over. What is it about Optic Gaming in particular that allows them to do that?
They're one of the best teams at snowballing, using those specialists to your advantage. How many times have you seen Skumpy pop that kinetic armor and break in and get a two or three piece with Formal to follow up? But Elevate doing a great job. The biggest difference I see is Aqua holding his own in the sling. The first time these two matched up, he was struggling.
Now. It's starting, though. I mean, you see the three streak from Skump. You see all the kills in the feed.
The Tempest got wasted, too.
Yeah.
I think I heard it come out. Nothing connects at all. And on the other side, you still have your Scythe for Formal. So a little bit of an advantage there when you're talking about specialist weapons.
Nice pinch, though. Elevate able to take their time, work that last player in the hill. Facento doing very well with that. Oh, laser sight on most of these subs as well. You see on Elevate a little bit of a different strat, stealing it from most of these EU teams we saw this tournament.
And I really question why. I mean, we have not seen it at all in stage one or stage two up until this point. It's the first one we're seeing it. Naugafin's going to try and turn, not able to take out Skump, but Aqua inside of the hardpoint with the Man of War. And he's the one, I think, who can make the biggest difference in this series. He plays well. He can take over games.
Well, Aqua trying to go big here. Him and Felony combined for four in a row. You see the HC flying and gets tagged up. Doesn't matter. Felony there to cover, and they are both going off. Three in a row for Aqua. Felly now up to five. Let's take a look at his POV as he's going to hop out the HC. Look to cut off angles here as the flood will begin to come in for Optic Gaming. Sorry, pal. Comes around the back. Does have Black Jacket, but Felony still going off. Fully streaked out now, looking to do more damage.
He's on a six streak right now. Over a minute in the hill. These streaks will come in handy. I want to see him save them for this third hard point on the rotation, but still going off in the hill.
Is it the laser? Is it the laser? The EU team's going off with it. And now you see Felony making an impact. A nine streak. Kinetics in. He's about to get the HC yet again. This is impressive stuff.
And he's the one player in this match who is like unproven. No experience in a match of this caliber. And he's going off here in this first hard point.
It's one of his first tests. Now we see Elevate wrapping around the back.
Kinetic here.
Popping
comes,
Kinetic. Is he going to go in and pop the first kill? Yes, he does. Heat wave to counter though. Aqua and Nagafuin.
He
picks up the last one. Great plays from Fellow.
Oh, Crim picks up one before that, but you see the turn and burn coming out for Felony. The streak's at 11. He makes it 12. This is insane stuff. The youngster proving he can hang with the best.
How many we have never seen a streak like this against Optic ever. I'm convinced. I do not have any stats in front of me to prove that. He's 28 and 12 with a minute and 47 in the hill. An unreal game here.
He's still going. He hasn't lost a goal. Felony, stop it. 30 and 12. 15 streak. Carrying the side of Elevate. And here come the streaks, baby. This is absolutely insane. Finally, he drops. But look at that stat line. Insane, insane stuff.
You see Optic spawning out at that glass side now. Elevate going to have this intro time on the rotation. Lightning coming in. Aqua able to open up. Optic trying to do their best to get these spawns, but when someone is slaying so heavily like this, he has over a 2.0 KD right now. All the hill time for his team. Fellow coming out hot.
Hey, but now Formal trying to answer here, able to pick up a Karma, a couple Karma closing out as well. And now this power position, the Scythe is out. You shouldn't be shocked to see that. Don't peek out. You're going to get dropped. That's one assist. Can Formal keep it going? They've got a big climb to do. And TP, okay, you guys have to admit something. What did I say before this game?
I'm not giving you credit.
What did I say?
We were joking around, and Maven was like, I feel like Elevate's going to come out and take the hard point. So we were like, you won't tweet
we
that.
Looked at
he's
him like
right, because my phone would die. It would just shake and then just lose all battery.
Oh, I did not expect this performance from Felly.
They're coming back, though.
You hear the crowd getting behind Optic, trying to pick things up and claw back in. You got streaks now building for Formal and Karma. Can they shut down Glass? This is a hard point, which you can pick up a ton of time if you can lock it down.
They got to get these streaks on Formal. That would be massive. Ooh. He's going to get one. He's going to pick up the second as well. He's going to get the Lightning and the Hellstorm. Can he pick up the Cerberus? So you see the score start. Starting to mount in Optic's favor. They're starting to pick up kills. This is scary. This is where Elevate
Look at the
they
top
need
right.
to slow it down.
Look
they
at the
need
top
to slow
right.
it down. They need to take their time. They need to make a good
push.
Oh,
by Tempest getting nothing done. That's the second shutdown. TP, oh, they're almost on a 20 streak combined for Optic. This is insane. Oh.
They do this time and time again. Last time we saw it was on that stronghold hard point, and this is where it gets scary. Elevate needs to slow down, take their time, and get this water control. Good intro in from Aqua, but can they answer? Crim starting to line up the scoreboard as well. A little bit of a struggle to start, but he went on like a five or a six streak.
Team, to me, with the smokes, it looks like that Elevate's starting to get a little bit desperate, that they're starting to doubt themselves a little bit. What they were doing so good early is they were confident. They were challenging those gunfights, not scared. It is Optic Gaming, though, taking the fight to them. They are bringing this one very close.
Oh, my God. Is the comeback real? Down by as much as 100. They're trying to bust in. The guy that lit up the first hard point, Formal, he's got the Hellstorm, got the Lightning to work with. We'll see how those are used in the preceding hills. But right now, just shutting it down with the Man of War. He's 33 and 21. What's nuts to think about? His stats, okay, from a pure slang standpoint, right on par with Felony despite that crazy streak. So he's slowed down a little bit on the other side of things.
Formal completely took over what Fellow what is lacking now. Completely just looking over his teammates, reminiscent of the first hard point on the first rotation.
And these smokes, it looks like easy pickings here for Formal. Keeps it going. He had a seven streak. Now six. He wants seven yet again. The Cerberus, he's 100 off it. Bringing it back, Formal going nuts.
Elevate is just throwing smokes and trying to contest. I mean, there's still 2 minutes and 30 seconds left on the game clock. It's not like they can run the clock all the way down to zero. They need to fight these battles straight up. And it looks like Optic's going to get very close to taking the lead. I like what we're seeing at the top of the mini-map, though. It's everybody from Elevate going over towards that second hard point. They're playing for that.
Exactly. Formal holding down this back helipad on this anchor spawn. You definitely need the back if you're going to have success on this kitchen hill. These gunfights are going to be huge to break. Karma and Crim get the first couple. Kinetic is burned as well. Crim and Formal enter in, and now the lead change is going to happen. Streak coming out for Optic. Will they get any kills? Formal gets one.
Yeah, you called in a lightning and a hellstorm. The streak's coming up big. Formal's broke the 40 mark, and there's the lead change. The green wall advancing. Can they close out game one? Trailing by as many as 100 points, and now Crimson on 8 streak. The streaks have been ludicrous for the side of Optic Gaming. How has Elevate watched this ball?
And Elevate's at a point where they can't even rotate and give up on this. They gotta challenge the time, and you see the smokes. Now it works out. They're able to take control of the hill. If you're elevating your comms, you gotta slow things down, take a deep breath, take this time, and really focus down in this next
TP,
rotation.
TP, you've been in this spot. There's no room for breathing. It's basically a tie game. 225, 225. These guys pushing for the rip, but Optic is set up here at the first hard point. How are they looking to hold this down?
They have to try and work up middle right now, this Elevate squad, but Scumpy in the hill, putting down shots. Formal at the back as well. Fellow able to open up at mid, but Optic's setup is too strong. Formal taking over once again. Gunfight from Nagafin, one at AC, but Hellstorm coming in. Spawn kills from Ooh! Optic. Crim able to pick up another one.
They can't get close. They cannot get close to the hill. It's going to be Aquado picking up 3 big kills. Formal pulls out the scythe, needs to go big here for Optic. He's going to get one, needs to challenge the hill, though. This gunfight at top AC
this
is huge.
This is coming needs down to the wire. Fire. It's going to be a tie game. 243, 243.
Formal's
where's
got
the
to make a
for
play.
Optic Gaming? You have Formal coming around the back. Scythed out. One above, one left, one right. Can he find all? Oh. There's two. Scump is in. They only need a few more points. Where are the points coming from? It's Felony inside.
Oh, Elevate takes it. They Woo! Barely hold on. Oh my. Elevate takes the hard point. Something I don't think anyone in the venue expected.
Other than me. And I don't know why I said it.
Other than the man in the orange blaze that nobody trusts.
The reason I said that is I feel like
you have
Elevate,
no idea what's going
no,
on.
Elevate knew they had to win this. To win the hard point and have a chance at a best of five, you almost need to steal it from Optic Gaming. I don't know what's in their water, but what a ridiculous, ridiculous hole, because Optic came screaming back, man.
Man, Elevate got too frantic right there, in my opinion. Oh my gosh, Fellow was able to close out with the 40 bomb in close to 2 minutes in the hill. He's the one that set the pace. He's the reason on that, 14 streak on that second and first hard point. He's the one that set the tone for Elevate. They were able to close it.
And to mount the comeback for Optic, wow. You needed a crazy game from Formal. We talked about how good Felony was. I believe Formal finishes 48-25. A sick game.
Insane, insane stuff. For our game one of the grand final, our wonderful analysis desk. What was that?
All right, thank you, Maven. He's all done squeaking, but can we make some noise in here, guys, for both of these teams? What a way to start the championship match. Merc, you called it. You said these are the players to watch. It's going to be Karma and Felony. You should have said Formal, but you got the Felony part right.
50%.
His first championship match, probably the best start to anyone's championship career that we've ever seen.
Yeah, I mean, he just, you know, he uses that laser sight, something that you wanted to talk about. And then he goes on a 15 streak, and he was really the reason why they got to that 100-point lead. But then Optic, I said it earlier as well, that glass hill, that's really where they started to turn it around. They all started to get some streaks, and it was just a very scary sight from there.
I honestly thought the potential Elevate throwing it away. You see Optic just start heating up. The crowd gets behind them. The scoreline gets closer and closer. They actually get into the lead as well.
Off the lightning, right?
Yeah, and that's huge. I mean, two rounds in, only 50 off of a lightning. It's a pretty good start. We're going to actually see in the final kill game here. Nagafin TO6 shot. Let's see.
Oh,
no.
He got tagged for. Oh,
no
God.
Way.
Oh. Well.
He's like, hello, come believe it. Even Mr. Mid-Map shocked.
Seriously. Gameplay from right. Naga. Able to get those first couple kills. And then not only that, he bought so much time for his team while they were getting that bomb down. Backed up rocks. Delayed the two Optic players at the rocks. Able to secure the round.
I have to at least watch him off the break. But if he doesn't get any, we have to go back to Karma. Because he's 50 off the lightning. On the offensive side of things, it's tied up 1-1. If he keeps this going, I mean, getting the lightning would definitely be a big plus here.
It'd be massive, but Teep, when we see Nagafin playing over at that B site, it's very difficult to break in. I mean, I guess, what are your options at that point?
I guess you either have to try and counter-snipe him when he's trying to hop over those back B trees, but Optic just doesn't want to mess with it at all. Seem to be working up at this bottom mansion, working up towards A. They don't want to mess with that B because they know Nagafin's position is so strong.
Well, Felony playing behind Lambo has an angle on a player at this site. This is one of the tougher gunfights in the game, really back and forth when you have the site as cover, you have the car as cover. No one really getting too many shots in, trying to battle here. Second player comes over, finally he is gonna fall, but a kill is traded out as Crim6 also drops. 3v3, 30 seconds to work with. Karma still going off. He's 8-0. He's got the lightning. He has the heat wave. Can he clutch for his team? He's weak around the back. Doesn't choose to use the heat wave there. But now Formal. Opportunity to clutch. Has two more to pick up. 20 seconds to work with. Has the bomb in his hand. Oh, just as he looks forward. Still moving. I thought for sure he was dead to rights, but now just not enough time to make a play.
And I tell you what, I mean, Optic's pretty fortunate. Damon gets off to the start because there's a chance Elevate's up 3-0 in this. They don't have streaks. This could have been a blowout.
Exactly. Streaks on this map are very, very useful. You want to try and play off of this, especially on your defenses. You can use that dart. You can use that lightning to zone them out and make them play slow. I liked how Elevate played that, though. They're not taking any risks. The first time these two teams matched up, they kept peeking into Formal, getting punished for it. This time, playing it safe, grouping up, and playing that 2v1 very well.
Well, let's check if we're back to a sniper battle. No, it looks like Formal's put it away for now, so it's going to be Naga that's still trying to leave a mark on this one. Can Elevate get a 3-1 advantage here as they're playing offense, just trying to wallbang? We talked about the fact that he is going to have FMJ on this PO6. It looks like a gunfight may go down here at Bunker. Shots on Formal. Wins it first blood towards Optic
Gaming. And that's one that Aqua needs to win. He has such a great advantage there behind that cover, and, I mean, you can only see his head. Formal just picks it up pretty easily. I mean, he wasn't even really tagged up by Aqua. It's going to be Felony, though, jumping in the top mansion, able to get one, quickly traded out by Crim. It's going to leave just Vicento and Nogafin to figure out how they're going to attack this. And Vicento's getting lost behind enemy lines. I think they actually hear the glass break, though, and that's where they know Vicento's coming from behind. Scump's able to take him out. It's going to be just Nogafin left here in the 3v1.
Nogafin's done some crazier things. Rhino, please don't hit that. He'll drop. Nice shot. So Formal gets that first blood, and Bunker ends up getting the final kill out by the B-bomb site, and Optic Gaming has brought it back.
Teep, at least in my opinion, just kind of watching the game this far, I feel like their chance to kind of like take it over has already passed. Like,
definitely
I feel like they needed to like start off this, like these first four rounds, like 3-1 or 4-0 with the way the game was going. Yeah, at least in my opinion, I'd love to get your insight. Do you think they're just letting Optic hang around for too long here?
I completely agree with you on that one, especially when these streaks are going to come into play from Karma. It should, if they use them correctly, secure them at least one or two rounds.
Looks
I want
like
to see Elevate
time.
Take some more map control, just like Nogafin is doing right now, working up very quickly up this minimap. Don't see anything yet, but Optic is rocking with a pretty slow setup.
Well, the dart is now out. Will this actually work out for Karma? They aren't able to hunt him down. Now he's looking for kills. Three shots out. Just one tag. Looking to dip and dive. Oh, both having flak jackets. So only Nogafin ends up dropping as a result.
Well, it's a huge kill, too, because Crim is actually looking over Karma. And when we go into the cam on Karma's dart, he only sees three. And they're all mid-map. You figure Nogafin always plays that back tree. Nogafin decides to flank that round. Crim picks it up. If he doesn't
Heads
pick
up
that
one.
Up, Naga would have taken out two, three players.
Look at the flank here. Aqua may be in behind. They transfer over, but Karma not ready for Aqua to win that one. But everyone's starting to push in for Optic Gaming. They're flying in to Mansion. There's one for Crim. He's got the glitch to work with. They've got control of Mansion. And you've got Aqua trying to rotate all the way back around from Bunker. Have him high limit. Don't have a ton of time to work with. Need to win this gunfight. He uses the glitch. The bomb is getting planted. Now it's Aqua. What, back-to-back rounds in a 1v3.
Really good stuff from Optic right there, taking control of that mansion. Once they got those numbers, Aqua trying to do his best to make those numbers back in their favor, but now stuck in a very tough situation. This round is huge as well, one of the swing rounds for this squad.
He's getting close to Heatwave. I don't think he gets it during this round. I mean, maybe if he picks up one, he'll get it, but still, I don't think you have enough time to really make an effective play on it. There's one up top. It's going to be Scum challenging. Optic takes the lead, and this is where I think you can see the game go in their favor, right? I mean, you know, they hold serve. Now they go on the other side. I feel like, you know, they win this next round on the defensive side of things. I feel like they're in pretty good shape.
Yeah, kind of a counter there from Optic.
Yeah.
Elevate was trying to get a little bit more aggressive up towards mid-map, but Nogafin ends up getting trapped into that bottom satellite building. But like you said, it was such a heads-up play from Crim watching over his teammate. Nogafin actually spotted Karma in the back of their spawn, but Crim was there to take him out before Karma was even injured.
All right, well, let's kick it off with Aqua on offense here. Optic Gaming has a one-round advantage. Elevate trying to bounce back. Nogafin hits straight up mid-street, says, okay, you want to give me the B site? I'll take it. The early plant is in. Now Formal, though, might have a challenge here at Bunker. He won it last time, and there it is again. Aqua not able to win those key engagements, but the HC able to pick up one. Elevate now has two left, trying to win one in the back. That's Vicento coming up big. It's now a 2v2, boys.
And Crim falls off the map as well.
Oh, that's
so
good.
That is huge. So that's going to even it up at a 2v2 man count. It's going to be Vicento over at half wall. Now comes the lightning strike. He's got to get out, but doesn't pick up anybody with it. This is a really good round for Elevate.
Well, if you don't win that one, they might be able to stick it. I'm guessing. Let's take a look at Karma. He's on it.
Does Nog have the sniper?
No, he had them eight. He had them eight. The shot's in. He can't get the kill.
Oh.
And Karma with the stick will take the round.
No way. You have to expect Nagafen to hit those shots right there. Have an M8. His shot was a little bit shaky
almost,
right there.
Well, it's almost like the kind of the aim assist of the other player jumping up there may have affected it a little bit. He sort of jumped into the shots, took some bullets for Karma.
Oh, man. You totally expect Elevate to take that round, especially after they sort of wasted that lightning. You're not sure if you're going to pick up one there. You want to use that in a situation where you have bomb down.
Yeah.
I still don't think it's an awful round for them. I mean, the lightning gets burned there. They go on the defensive side. I would definitely favor the defensive side over the offensive one on Stronghold SMD. You expect them to be able to take this round as long as they play it smart.
Really weird thing as well. We saw Aqua trying to push up that bunker and get taken out by Forma. Nagafen with a nice snipe to open up the round there at middle. Seems to be more comfortable with the snipe on Stronghold and making some good moves with it.
Well, depending on how far, I'll keep Formal highlighted, as he starts to inch forward in bunker, depending on the timing, he might run into a blainer here from the side of Nagafen, as he has not really been missing in this one. Just keeping him highlighted for now. On the other side of things, we'll look at Crim6 and crew are starting to poke forward. Where's the push going to come from? It looks like the first end's going to be Skump and Crim here. They're starting to get in towards Mansion. I'll highlight Formal as well at the top. We'll try to see when the break comes in.
With Kinetic, I think Mansion's the better option here. I think, you know, obviously man down, your best chance is, well, Formal to pick one up here and then try and push the other two onto the site and use this Kinetic armor to secure the round.
Yeah, Elevate does have the numbers, though. Going into the last 30 seconds of the round, will Skump try and use this Kinetic to clutch up and get the numbers back? But a heat wave does go down. Skump now stuck in the 1v2, able to
he's
even back.
Fellow
behind him. Oh, that was close there. You get scared when Skump takes out two of your teammates, but Fellow makes the right play, flanks over from top Mansion, and secures the round.
Well, Skump's got Dart Lightning as well.
Yeah.
So now those burning the streaks of Karma is not that important because they get them right back. It'll be interesting to see if they can use them more effectively. I mean, they get nobody with the lightning.
And we talked about the fact that Karma was kind of carrying the load early. That has not been the case at all. I mean, he's slowed down and everyone else has started to turn up. So when you said Skump has, he has Kinetic, Lightning, Dart, a lot to work with. We'll see how he opts to play that out. But let's go back to the offensive side. We'll watch things come together for the side of Elevate.
You know what I would like to see here from Optic, Tyler? I would like to see them actually just push out over towards Snow Aggressive with the Kinetic. I think
really
would have caught Elevate completely off guard.
Exactly. If you're able to get that rocks control early in the round, it forces the other team to make a decision whether to wrap back and fight you or take the base. But now we have Fellow working up. Did he catch that player going up to back table? I don't think so. Another blind camo use from Formal. I don't necessarily agree with this.
I think the call came in that several were on the site, so he tried to push forward. Able to end up one. They push top, though. Can't win a second. Now Elevate looking to keep control of Mansion. You still have Crim6. Does he have an angle on these players?
He does, but not able to win it.
Karma might be able to win both. Can't do it. Felony, Vicento, guns up. Everyone getting involved from the Elevate side, and we're right back.
That's a swing round.
Yeah.
That's an offensive round where Optic gets man advantage, and I think the worst play of them all in that one was Crim at the B bomb site challenging top Mansion with the VMP. When you know that player has the M8, that's a pretty difficult shot.
Well, what's funny is I switched the Formal behind the site because you saw two players pushed up the B. As soon as he popped the camo, they ran right back and went straight into Mansion. So you end up kind of having that wasted camo. I know he gets one kill, but not really off the back of the camo. Doesn't lead to any more kills. And now it's going to be Optic back to offense.
This is a streak round. You can see with the way Optic's setting up. They're setting up to use one of these streaks here.
Yeah, exactly. It did work out for them the last time they tried to do this. It looks like another gunfight maybe going down at that bunker side. Those two arrows very, very close to each other. We'll see if anything's going to happen there. But Nagafen going back to his normal spot. He's flying over these trees, trying to spot any of these players middle. And I don't know what he's looking at right there, but he's trying to snipe the dart. Can he get it?
You see the shots coming through, trying to hit the dart. Can't be the easiest. You better run. You better. He's dodging. How is he dodging? He's still alive. Skump can't connect, and Nagafen will live. And we saw Nagafen's Aqua's angle at the top. Formal ends up pushing through, and they do get that kill inside a bunker. So this gets back to 3-3.
Yeah, but it's going to be another kill traded out. It's going to be Crim taking out Felony up top in Mansion, and that's going to give Optic some options. They're going to free up the A site, but now it's going to be a B sack from Elevate. Crim's got to make a play. The Lightning comes in. Okay, so they're going to get one, take out a teammate as well. Not a great use of a Lightning. I think Crim's going to challenge a player in back cube. He can't let this player stay alive for long because he's going to get pinched.
He lost him. I think he lost him. Now he's just spraying walls. Can't find him. Vicento taking it. And what is this? Is this going to be a 2-0 lead for Elevate? They are one round away from taking this search.
I think Karma uses Heat Wave there too and gets taken out by his teammates Lightning. So many things going wrong for Optic here. They're investing so much and getting nothing out of it.
That they use a camo in the round prior, they don't win it. That round, they use a dart, a lightning, and a heat wave.
What explains maybe the miscommunications here, Teep? What's off with Optic right now?
I really don't understand. It just seems like Elevate has the better movement at, you know, from Mr. Mid-Map himself. He is only 3-6, but he is getting a lot of these intro kills.
They do still have the kinetic.
Yeah.
So I think you can pretty much here, you can stack Mansion, and then if Elevate were to get up onto the B site, you probably have Skump intro yourself in with kinetic over to the bomb.
I think you have to at this point. You need to try and make a play, especially towards that mansion. But a slow round from both of these teams right here. Map is on the line for Optic. Can Elevate take this 2-0? They're looking really good here. Snipes going down from Nagafen. He does have this FMJ, remember that. So they need to be careful peeking him.
Well, also, Vicento has Vision Pulse. So he's actually going to pop it. You see it happen on the mini map, and I believe he's actually going to tag just one player up with it.
Well, look how far they backed up. Everyone backed up to basically back lot. Let's get back to Skump because this kinetic is going to be huge. The shot's a little off, but there's one. Got to chase it down. There's two. Skump bumping things up. 3v2. Optic has control for the moment. 35 seconds on the clock. Aqua in a gunfight in the back. Can't win it. Tagged up. Formal gets in. Vicento, it's now all on you, buddy. Can't win the gunfight. We're going to a round 11.
He's going to have an HC to work with. It's not, I don't think it's a game-changing deal, but I mean, it could come into play. You see Karma here in the final kill cam. They do burn the Vision Pulse in that win, but I think, look, you can't hate on that call. I think the Vision Pulse, you clear out Mansion. I probably would have said you go and get the bomb down at A. When you use the Vision Pulse over in Mansion, I think you use it to free up Mansion, and that's the harder site to retake, so I think that was the only mistake there from Elevate.
The mistake there is when that player from top table backs down, that's when you take control of it. There's really not much Optic can do to take it back, but regardless, Skump able to open up that round with the kinetic armor.
Well, offense going to be for Elevate. He had, Nagafen had the PO6 out, switched to this Man of War. I know we've talked about it quite a bit. You saw somebody over the top in the back. I believe you have AR and AR. So Formal's going to be rocking the AR as well. Let's check out Vicento because he's going to have the HC out, trying to check the B-bomb site, get what information he can as his teammates will start to push. The HC somehow going to live on the cross, but now they're beginning to inch forward. I have Nagafen highlighted. They're starting to move probably behind.
He's
this
really
HC.
Not gaining the mini information here as well, because that's a pretty common spot that player plays up in top table inside Mansion. Well, now you gain them a bunch of information. He sees two players over at B. You know, the one guy is up top, so you know there's one player down at A. He's going to bring it in. Flak Jacket saves both those players. And you believe you see on Felony screen, he saw that player cross. I imagine he knows this player is directly to his right. Well, now he definitely knows, but only 25 seconds left. What is Elevate planning here?
They got to make a play. Four up for either side. The push coming in, you have one wrapping all the way around the back. That's going to be Vicento. He may be in on the flank.
He's got to go.
They spot him. They spot him. He has to go. They've got bomb down. Now trying to make it. Tags up one. Kills the other. He's getting chased. Can't get gun up. 2v2 in round 11. It's now all on Scumpy. He's got a clutch. He's behind one. He's not going to be able to do it. Elevate up 2-0 in our first best. One thing. This just made me laugh. Elevate hasn't 3-0'd a team in the entire season. Is that where you were going to go?
Yeah,
great minds think alike.
The biggest thing is, like, throughout this entire tournament, Elevate's been struggling. CWL have been struggling. Never gotten this 3-0. Will they get it here? They need to do it. I think they need to force this best of five.
One thing, too, with the ban and protect, Rapid Fire makes in the Shiva as well. I expect you to see the Shiva at some point.
Well, things open up quickly here as three kills come in for Optic Gaming. That was all four down, and now they're pushing forward. Crim6 getting into Grandma's, looking for the one-point toss up over the top, and good. Optic on the board early.
Good stuff from Krim right there. I really don't like him taking it into Granny, though. You really want to try and work that ball up at this right alley. The alley that Karma is trying to clear out right there. But regardless, Krim, good heads-up play. Gets the one, and now the map control battle begins. Skump left at middle. Needs to do a good job trying to get this first kill if he can, but Elevate doing a great job getting it back. Aqua with the two-piece.
Well, I'll tell you what. Optic striked early, but I want to see how they sound looking for the closeout game for Elevate. Let's toss it to an Astro listening.
Two there.
Good try. There's two. We gotta slay, guys. We gotta slay.
Get the door later. Next to you, one shot, Seth.
Mid. Watch out, mid. Our tank. Ball's going mid.
One shot.
Balls kill ball.
Got me. Two guys there. Nice. One more Damon.
They missed.
Play. One's close to you.
Get him out of our base, guys.
Yep. Let's be serious.
Watch out our tank, guys. We gotta kill. He's holding the wall.
Barn one shot Aqua.
He went all the way in the back. Yep.
I got shot in the mid. Set up. Tour grape.
Back right, Matt. He's behind there.
Same back here with you, Ian.
Nice one.
Play intercept. One's close. They might be playing the dunk.
Get him. One more.
That's us, guys. Nice. Let's go. Get aggressive.
Everyone chill. We're fine. Then barn.
Alright.
They're tanked.
Nice. One more tank.
Two.
One more tank.
It's weak.
I got him.
Let's go.
Last guy, top piece.
I'm running through broken.
He's still up there?
Yep. He's still here. I'm braving him.
Matt, I'm dropping the ball slain.
Nice one.
Yeah, we're coming.
Back right. In the alley, one shot. Charging you, one shot.
No, two. Fuck.
Two there.
Two. He's in broken.
Okay. Watching it.
He's got an AR. Seth, you just push him.
Another one. Two there, Seth.
Oh, nice. I'm coming broken, Seth.
I'm going to shot the back. Go mid lane. They're mid.
He's going B stairs right now. Nice.
Somewhere.
I'm going left.
Yeah, he might wrap left.
I'm coming to you, bro.
They might still wrap. Watch my mid, guys. I'm holding B.
I got middle. Go help him, Seth. Left.
Broken. One shot Aqua. Broken. One shot Cliff.
There's two.
Aqua's one.
Well, you hear the listen in there with Optic Gaming. I mean, they sound all right. I like Formal saying, we're all right. But the thing is, you're down two right now. Elevate's been doing an excellent job of kind of controlling mid map, not allowing Optic to get too much pressure.
I hate when you keep hearing the we're all right, because that makes you kind of think in the back of your head, like, we're not all right. You see a dunk come in there. For Elevate, they jump out to a 5-1 lead. Teep, what have you noticed such far?
Facento absolutely putting the pressure on there. Picks up three, opens the lane with the camo dunk. Elevate extending their lead to four on this one. Felony taking over at Grave. Three for him. Now pushing up for another dunk. Can they get it? Oh. Melee trying to go down. I don't like that play right there. You need to try and play that one and stay alive. Skump going clutch, though. Got to give him props. But the ball is now wrapping left. This is Optic's chance to make this score a little
bit
closer.
That wasn't a good play by Elevate. They should have just taken the one-point play there. They got a little too greedy.
Well, they're feeling confident. I would, too, if I was up 2-0 right now over Optic Gaming. Skumping crew pushing forward. Krim leading the way. The melee comes in. Buddy drops. Who's there to pick it up? Looks like it'll be Krim. Karma trying to clear the way. Everyone dropping. Camo pop. There's the dunk. They're now down by two. Optic trying to scream back into this one.
Extremely heads-up play from Optic there, and that's what happens every single time. Elevate makes a little bit of a lapse in judgment, could have got the one, could have contained Optic in their base, but instead the point swing goes into Optic's favor, but Aqua taking this ball up quick towards middle, but is taken out. Another greedy play from Elevate, punished by Skump.
That's 2 points now, right? Let's keep a tally. That's two that you should have had that Elevate have not put through. The drone now gonna be with Optic. You see kind of this four-man defense set up by Elevate trying to deal with any pressure coming in. Let's go actually over to Skump because he's the drone carrier. He does have Kinetic to work with as well, but he can't get it out. Not able to get the toss. You see Formal coming from the back. Krim still pushed up by Grandma's, but not a lot working offensively for Optic Gaming
now. I like the idea not to use the Kinetic there. I'm not a fan of the Kinetic drone combination. I think you use the Kinetic to push in front of the drone to pick up
or
kills.
Or win back mid-map, right?
Yeah, in a crucial gunfight to get mid-map. But the final seconds here, let's see if Facento can get across the Grave and get this one-point throwdown. Yeah,
here comes the toss. Not a lot of time left. There it is. 6-3 lead. You turn it into a two-possession game. TP, what is Elevate doing right now?
It's all about that graveyard. Felony doing a great job in the spot that he's in over there, opening the lanes for his team, and that's why they're able to pick up those ones. But you got to think, is those missed out points going to hurt Elevate? They're doing a great job of holding this map control, pinning Optic back in their base, but you got to think this game should be 8-1. That huge lapse in judgment, not going for those two ones from the graveyard, could have pinned Optic in the base for the whole
eight
half.
8 points would have been nice in the first half.
That's what you
Elevate. You would have felt really comfortable going into the second half.
All right, well, let's get into side two, see if OpTic can bring it back. They almost came roaring back in game one, almost took that round 11, but that's what it's been, almost. They have not been able to take a game yet in this series. Is Uplink will where they will get it done. You see Felony, he's got the kinetic. What else do we have? Aqua looks like he has a scythe as he drops. You have, I think, maybe it was Skump that was also working on his ability for the other side here for OpTic Gaming. But now you see Formal picking up kills. Krem coming in as well. Formal able to snap across. Looks like a kinetic armor was used. He can't finish up the kill. Can he pick it up? The assist comes in for Skump. They've got control now. No, they don't. I take it back. The scythe is out for Aqua. He's lining everybody up. There's two. Finds three. Aqua punishing everybody. And now Elevate screaming forward yet again.
And I wish you could see Teeps and I's face. When we saw that kinetic come in from Felony, we were shaking our head no. When we saw the scythe come in, we were shaking our head yes. You see Nagathen pops his camo.
He's got it in.
He's got a teammate there. Felony picks up two, not able to pick up the last one. Huge defensive stand from OpTic.
I don't even think that was a lapse from Elevate. Honest, I like them going for that camo dunk there, but OpTic able to clutch up again.
They
could have got the one, but Aqua Scythe trying to open it up did a good job, but still no points for Elevate. When you get pushes like that, you have to get something on the scoreboard.
Well, let's take a look now as OpTic trying to get pushed forward. They've gotten into Barn. It's going to be Crimsix with Skump. This should be a one-pointer over the top. Can't get it off. Is Skump able to make a play? The shot's off point, and Elevate stands. They're holding on this far. They need to play the possession game. Just keep this drone out of OpTic's hands.
And where I think Rapid Fire plays the biggest difference in this game on Uplink is taking out the drone carrier, because the Rapid Fire, you know, you just churn out those bullets, you melt that player,
this
and you're able
dangerous.
To take him out with the easy. And yeah,
this is real
the drone
dangerous.
Down in a really bad spot. Grim's trying to come over the top.
He doesn't get it away.
Nope.
Doesn't get it away. Can he find the second? Backs him up. Drone still, I mean, if Skump would have stayed alive on the other side, he would have felt real, real good about maybe points coming in for OpTic Gaming. But now it's going to be about the charge forward for Elevate. They're pushing Snow Street. They're going to get pinched on and collapsed, and that's four dead. You got to get points here now.
They're going to OE this.
Has grabbed the drone. They have to push forward. Why not? You have four now. It's time to make a play. You have Skump going, leading the way around the back, trying to apply pressure while Karma looks to get the toss off. Crimsix picking up kills inside. Formal's busted out the site, and this will be a dunk. Right back to Formal. He's got the site, looking for the kills. He's already got three. Where's the spawn coming? It's basically there at Front Church. He doesn't catch one before mid-map, and he will get picked off, so the rally may stop there.
Good patience from Karma right there, waiting for Formal to run through with the site. Scythe, good specialist use. Both Scythe players doing a great job opening the map for their teammates. Score a little bit closer now. OpTic has this middle control. Karma, very dominant when he has it. Spawn kills going down. Can he pick up the third? Felony trying to answer back, but ball, or drone, sorry, is working through Church. Another dunk going in for OpTic. Looks like they're going to be able to get it. But no, Vicento shuts it down.
And this is the last man.
It's a huge play there by Vicento. The guys on the desk mentioned they needed to see him step up in this one. Those are two massive kills, save some points.
Well, there's been some sick defensive holds from both sides. Like, where you thought for sure a dunk was going in, stopped right at the goal line. These guys just going off for their squads. It's the grand final. Aqua can't get it off. You see the last two players, they're pushing back to mid-map. It's now OpTic's turn. I feel like there's been so much back and forth, like a tug of war, but no one's really getting points on the board.
It's interesting, because usually from the side that OpTic is on, you want to keep pushing that gray there. You get those one-point throws, but they have not been able to do it to where it seems like right now they've just resorted to try and go on that B street and try and get those throws over the top.
Yeah, weird sort of stalemate situations going on in this left streak and kills going back and forth. Aqua keeps trying to push up this lane, clear out the B, S, and D, able to pick up one. Can he do the second? No, Skump there to wrap back. Force the drone to wrap back is what I'm trying to say. Good play from Nagafen. Heads up, trying to keep this control. Minute left. All they really need to do is waste time. They can't force any more situations, because if they do, OpTic will punish.
Well, I like this. You toss it back to mid-map team. Make sure you have gun up. Able to win one gunfight. Nagafen going big for his squad, but the pressure now going to be coming. OpTic maybe have one or two opportunities here to tie this one up or go for the W. There's someone mid-map. He sees him. He's behind. Is the melee there? He's coming in. Krim's at the melee. There's the one-point toss over the top, and the pick isn't there. Tie game. 6-6. 35 seconds on the clock, and it may be Skump coming all the way back to mid-map that has to win some key gunfights here and make sure Elevate cannot push it forward.
And OpTic has to be careful that Elevate doesn't get the drone, bring it back towards their side, go down the B street and get a one-point throw off to end it, but it's going to be Skump passing the drone up to Krim. He's going to try and lead the charge.
All those shots are sick.
Krim
here it
getting
is.
The drone.
The camo.
In the throwing
the toss down.
He's dropped. The drone down, it does not look like anyone close enough for Optic to get it, and it looks like we're going OT.
5 seconds. Is no, there wait. Any possibility? No. Don't think so. No, oh. Can't even get it off, and we're going to OT, baby. Could these games be any closer? And I think what you said about rapid fire, yeah, people seem to be getting melted with the drone. It almost seems like they don't even have that added armor, right?
The drone carriers are used to like being able to run around the map a little bit, but every single time just getting melted at exactly that last play there. Shot through camo. I thought Krim was going to be able to get that one off, but no, he was not.
Remember how we talked about when it was the last time this OG roster got 3-0'd?
Was
May
it March?
Of last year.
Oh, my gosh.
Season 2.
What? That's a long time.
That's absolutely
very
insane.
Long time. We have never seen, I don't want to say never seen anything like this, but it's been a very, very long time since we've seen anything like this. But here at the start at OT, it's going to be NagaFan popping his camo, getting the drone over to a nice position where it's going to force Optic to move around on the defensive end. He's got Aqua leading the charge. This could be a quick one-point throw. Big kills come in from Krim, though. But do they know Aqua's in this position?
I don't think so. They do hunt him down. Facinto's still here. He has a heat wave. If he could have popped, that might have connected with everybody, but drops before he can make a play. And now Formal, they're on the attack. They're looking to push this out and grab Drone to get forward. The kill's coming in, but they don't have Formal to work with here. Can Karma win it? It's Krim picking it up. Two kills go down mid-map. A third might be here if Karma can pick it up, but he gets away to Green Alley, but the pressure still coming in as Krim 6 holds the line. Karma now, here it is. Maybe the toss at the 60-second mark, wants the dunk, going for more. The Scythe in the back, bobbing and weaving. The kills are there, and there's the dunk for Optic Gaming.
Great heads-up play from Karma. He was on the wall run, set up to do the one, but got the call out from his teammates, dropped back down, knew they needed to get that dunk, a minute 6 on it. The
this
Scythe
kill.
Is wasted as well on Elevate's
wow.
side. And it, what a clutch kill from Formal
listen,
to protect
it's, it's
Karma.
It's been a long time since we've seen this Elevate, formerly TR roster duo, but they used to have a lot of set plays at the beginning of
true.
Uplink games in AW where they would get the drone, they would throw it over a building to a flanking player, and they would get an easy dunk. See if anything like that breaks out here in the beginning, and you see Aqua going down that top street. If he kills Karma, don't be surprised if they try and get that drone to that side of the map.
I'll keep him highlighted on the top of the map, but yeah, right, if he can win one gunfight, maybe they try to go over the top. Felony and Krim picking up kills. Everyone on Optic falling. Aqua's in the back. Does the toss come over the top? NagaFan holding for now. They might have it. There's the pass forward. It doesn't connect. Who gets the kills? It's Gump and Karma going up big. And now coming from the back, they've held on for now. 30 seconds left. You thought for sure that was a dunk as they started to push up.
It was a good executed play. Just not able to stay alive long enough. And now Karma. He's going to just play the clock here, 20 seconds left, no reason to push this up. His teammates just need to pick up kills. If they get close, just needs to toss it off the map.
Good He's stuff waiting. From Optic, just holding us in their base. Formal pulls out the slice just to make sure the reset goes down, and looks like Optic is going to force a map 4 in this first best of 5 in the grand finals. Clutch plays from them. Elevate, let this one get away. So many mistakes. Ooh. Optic able to take control and punish as per usual.
Is this the beginning of the reverse sweep? They clutch up in OT, and if we know
kill, so it really depends on the type of player that your team has. You can argue that a heat wave is more valuable than a camo.
Yeah. Just depends, right? All right, so as we get into this, I cannot remember, you know, we had a matchup earlier, I think it was Infused, I can't remember the exact match, but we were looking at both players with Overdrive,
there,
and you saw some, well, you saw one team use
yeah.
Overdrive very, very well.
It was
for two caps.
PD didn't use it very well.
Yes, and PD did not use it very well. So NagaFan, I mean, if he doesn't make good plays with it, it doesn't end up hurting you that much, but let's see what he can do. He's got the HVK out early. We don't see it that frequently for our North American rosters, but he cannot hit the edge. But you see, he was already a quarter way towards that overdrive 5 seconds into the game.
Well, why the HVK, Teeth?
I think it's a really good sort of run-of-the-mill AR. You can get a little bit aggressive with it is what I'm trying to say. It's your sort of hybrid type of AR you can use for those post-quarter gunfights, but back to the action. Skump getting in, getting this flagpole, picks up that first player, Aqua, trying to answer back, but lots of kills going down. Karma's able to get this flag out to Barn, crosses over towards Train, and now Elevate has to try and cut this off.
And Krim, that kill was huge because might have gotten angle to take out Karma, but now you've wrapped the corner, and that's going to be 1-0 lead for Optic Gaming.
And then you got Krim pulling the flag again. He's actually going to lose that gunfight on the other side of the map, potentially at a rally set up there. It's going to be Formal taking out another player, currently on a 4-streak. He gets dropped, and Yeah, the map kind of reset a little bit, but that looked way too easy from Optic Gaming. Obviously, going towards Barn, easier to get that flag out. But still, Elevate needs to kind of hold this to what? I guess you would ideally like to hold it here, but I think if they go down two flags, you still feel okay?
Another flag going out already for Karma. Skump keeps opening the door, but there is a player from Elevate trying to sneak through. It is Aqua putting shots down at that wood wall.
He's
but
distracted.
Looks like he's taken out, and Karma able to get that second one. Skump doing a great job getting through
Karma,
bar, opening
right.
the door.
Karma has two scores, and he's 0-1.
It's impressive work when all your teammates are getting those kills at Barn.
It's
he
a TP stat
in.
Line.
It really is.
He spent the whole game running flags so far. Insane statistic, and Optic keeping on the pressure. It looks like, you know how we talk about the fact that sometimes they have slow starts to hard points? It looks like they just had a slow start to this series, and now they've come alive. They had another flag out for just a second. McCrim does end up dropping. You do have a dart ready for Karma. He's on a two streak now. Felony on the other end, you know how we talk about how good, well, Felony and Pacento are combined for 1-14.
It's not ideal.
No, it's not.
No, not a very good start for those guys, and I think that's probably a big reason why you see two flags go in pretty early. And it's very difficult, I think, Steve, you can speak to this, to get going on a map like this, because it's so long, and it's very difficult to go against like an SMG player when you're Pacento, like a good one like Skump on this map, because he's so accurate at range with that. And then going up against the assault rifle players on Optic, very difficult as well.
Using an SMG, you need to roam these sort of areas he's in right now, these fences, these tracks, the top barn. Skump has had the advantage in this one, opening those intro kills, allowing Karma to sneak through and pull that flag. Once you get in the barn, it's basically a free run. Pacento needs to try and slow it down. He's trying to here, but caught in the back from Krim. Skump coming back around, has the kinetic to use on this flag pull as well. Elevate players being pinched in. Looks like another flag coming out, but finally, Elevate trying to get a touch on the flag. Nagafen is trying to get it out towards Otto, but Krim is here. Overdrive goes in as well, able to pick up the first, but Pacento there for the trade.
But look at the dart coming in for Karma. Can he shut down the flag? Trying to chase it. The return comes in, and that's a dart to the dome as Aqua takes it, and that is Optic getting a third flag on the board.
But a player is snuck behind for Elevate. That's going to be Felony. You see him highlighted right now. We're on board with him, and if his teammates can pick up some kills at the base, he could potentially pull this flag back.
See if they can make a play. It's Felony and Nagafen. Nagafen, you saw, used the overdrive there to try and get that out, but this might be a good opportunity. Let's go to your flag carrier. Checking the back. Thinks he can get a little room. Saw one to the right. Is anyone going to clean it up? Aqua picking up kills. Felony picking up kills. This should be it. Yes, this will be one on the board for Elevate, and now they've got the opportunity to bring this back after it was a hot, hot start for Optic Gaming.
Finally, something going for Elevate now. Nagafen switching over to the CUDA, something we didn't see on the screen, on the minimap. It looked like Aqua absolutely destroyed Formal to get the cutoff for that flag, and finally showing some life from the Elevate side, getting some pressure, getting their barn control back. Another overdrive is ready for Nagafen.
I was going to say, normally you would say, well, not a lot of time left. Optic very good on the defensive end of things. Maybe they don't get another flag out, but with overdrive, anything is possible here.
Well, especially when you have the Scythe to back it up, but Nagafen does end up dropping, and Krim has grabbed the flag, coming right behind the Scythe carrier, and this should be a score. This will be the fourth cap in the first half for Optic Gaming. They are rolling here on Fringe.
We were talking about the specialist comparison between Krim and Nagafen. The camo used by Krim to get out the cross torch track, able to secure the lead back to 3 in this first half. Optic completely outplaying the map control compared to Elevate on this one. Well, that barn side has been a struggle.
Well, to be fair, I mean, you can't really make a great play with overdrive if you don't have map control.
True.
When you have a guy 2-12, there's a very good chance you don't have any map control.
Yeah.
It's going to be Optic Gaming a 4-1 at the half.
Overdrive hasn't really mattered much. You saw that they used once. Yes, he got out to 10, but ended up getting dropped. I believe he still has it here to use starting up the second half. But Optic, I mean, it doesn't help you when you're just, you're pinned, you're playing out of your base. How many touches did Optic actually have? Because they had 4 caps, and I'm pretty sure they had double that in pulls.
100% true. It looked like they kept flooding up 2 players up train and then 2 at that back alley, trapping all those players from Elevate either at middle map or barn, pinching out and getting those flags out so easily.
Yeah, Optic gets 7 touches on the flag there.
Well, 4, right? There were 4 returns and 4 scores, so 8 total, right? That's insane. I mean, in one half, 8 touches, that's a full game
typically.
Yeah.
It's absurd.
All right, well, TP,
What are your thoughts here for Elevate? What can they do to start bringing this back now that they've swapped sides and they're going to be pushing out of Grandma's?
It's all about pushing up that trains toward those fences I was talking about before. If you're able to get that barn control and pull that flag out, that's the first step you need to take. But hey, when you have Karma over there shooting at you from the white truck, it's going to be a struggle to get tracks. And now one Elevate player, Facento, stuck in the base. Will he be shot in the back? Karma flanks around. Another flag pull happening. Two players with him. Shots from Krim going down, trying to get these spawn kills. Kinetic eaten up by
he's
Felony.
Out. He's out.
Karma's out again.
That is a score. You get three down. The spawn comes in. And these have been, it's not like really Optic's been bullying one side. They've been split pushing really, really well. It's not even that they've really been forcing the spawns out that well either. They're just getting three, four down at the same exact moment. And they're having very uncontested scores.
Look, I think it's more to do with Felony, Facento, and Naugafin just not slaying well.
Oh, that helps.
I mean, look. Aqua's not doing great, 13 and 13, you're at even, but you need the other guys to be around that area. And a lot of those gunfights for Naugafin is him trying to get into the base, trying to make a play. I mean, without picking up two, three players on the way, he's not going to be able to use that overdrive effectively.
Well, this would be big, because Facento gets a score and Naugafin still has the overdrive. And I know it's a four cap lead, but you might be able to make a play here. That's a big one to get. You're in the heat wave. You still have Naugafin with the overdrive, but you've got to get a couple scores here, a couple scores quickly.
Yeah, plenty of time left as well for Elevate to try and get back, but like we said, the getting kills is the issue for them on this one. Need to try and get this tracks control. A huge kill going down from Facento. Has Felony's help, though. Need to try and push up, get this barn control. Another pull going in, but there is one player at the top.
Big
bar. Naugafin with that HVK, able to take him out. Another flag does get out. Looks like they're going to bring it within two, but Optic seems to be breaking back out of their base.
Oh my God, that's back-to-back caps. The darts out, the capture will go in. Not able to make a play here. Things seeming to fall apart for Optic. Can Elevate push back, turn this one into an incredible game four.
And Optic can't get desperate and start going on the overextension and forcing gunfights mid-map. And you see kills going in favor of Elevate in the feed. It's gonna be Krim tossing out. No tactical over here from Barnside. He's actually gonna pop camo, try and stay alive, wins the gunfight, and his teammates gonna win some gunfights in the kill feed. And he actually buys them enough time popping that camo to get through back alley. That's actually a pretty big play.
Yeah, exactly. Krim buying those crucial 3, 4, 5 seconds and taking one down with him with the camo, but the flood is happening up towards Trax. Karma able to trade the kill on his scuff. Two for him. Another flagpole looking imminent for Optic Gaming. Last player at that god spot, Heglitch at the back, the cargo cars. Formal able to take him out. A pull. Three players from Optic get that flag out, but Naugafin on the other side pulls to force the stalemate again. Two players converging on him though. Karma again opening with two. Ken Naugafin clutch. He has someone's help. Aqua is there. The 1v1 tending to happen right now. Skump is on him. Who wins it? Naugafin is able to, keeping his team alive.
That's a massive gunfight, but you still do have Formal pushing through, working on this return. He doesn't have streaks, a sight, anything to work with, but he's got his gun skill. Can't get it done at this point, so we are going to have a bit of a reset for the time being with Felony dropping in the back of the base. Now, for Optic with the two-cap lead, the more time that goes on here, you're feeling great.
Well, I actually like getting the flag out of Naugafin's hands there in an odd way, because now it frees him up to use overdrive and get towards the other side of the map to try and make a play for the return.
Well, instead of overdrive, he's got the dart out for the kill. Coming hunting, but you have Flakjack and able to save the day. But you need to rally two together. I mean, your only hope here is basically a return and a great overdrive use.
Yeah, pretty much. Naugafin needs to try and get these intro kills on the middle, but Formal and Karma are too strong. This opens the door for Optic to push up a little bit, put some pressure. Only 40 seconds left. I don't think there's enough time for Elevate to do it, but now the last-ditch effort. You see three players from the Elevate side working up towards this back alley. Karma's the last stand is picked off, but the flags are going to start moving around. The 1v1 over towards the Elevate bay. Formal is there. Can he find this player? Being juked a bit.
He's
nice movement, but only 20 left.
He can't find him. I don't know how you'll possibly change this together, but we see some crazy CTFs. Formal has been hunting this player for 20 seconds. There's the kill. There's the return. That'll be all she wrote.
Well, the return comes in.
I mean, with 10 seconds left. Two.
You saw overdrive popped by Naugafin. Not enough time to get across the map. And
we're going to a game five, man. Baby. The reverse sweep. Elevate may be getting nervous.
Great. It's like plays from Optic to conserve the lead on that map. Formal completely took over. Almost a 2.0 kill to death ratio, 27 and 14. That's what you expect from him on this map. But the one thing we see on the scoreboard, 8-23 from Fellow. That cannot happen in a match of this caliber.
That's a rough one, especially for an inexperienced player going into a big game five. That's not a good one to go into.
Well, and also, you have a big game one, right, Matt? And you talked about, what was his KD in CTF? He's been crushing.
I mean, 25 kills per respawn. He's the number two slayer in stage two in CTF.
That's a third.
Fights. Crowd getting hyped here at Anaheim. This is it. Can the reverse sweep go down, or are we going to force the second best of five?
Here we go. Let's kick off round one. The fans losing their minds a bit, but I love it. Anaheim is rocking, and here we go. Round one underway. Optic on offense. Let's get it going.
Yeah, and on the side of Elevate, Naugafin actually is going to be using the Locust. Actually keep an eye on, see if the sniper's coming to play, but it's going to be Felony picking up first blood. Formal putting down some shots here on top AC, and it seems like Optic's going for that mid-map control.
He's got one, he's got two, but it's Naugafin trying to get the shot over the top. Okay, he has backed out. Let's get back to mid-map. Who's hiding inside a hut? It was Felony. Formal's been able to clean it up. It's now Naugafin by himself. He does have a cooter to work with. He has the Locust as well. Let's see if he can pull off the 1v2. Hello, the shoulder peek ends up paying dividends as they've now spotted him out. The challenge comes in. He's backed up both Optic players, and they look like they are ready to rotate this over to A.
Good rotation over there from Optic. They were able to get the numbers back in their favor. They were down 2-4, but Formal working that middle map with Karma so well. Naugafin trying to get onto this bomb site. Two players at the setup at middle. Will.
No.
Karma does. First round going to Optic. That first round, I really thought Elevate was going to close that out. They got the intro kills at middle, but Formal and Karma able to catch the rest of the players at that middle hut.
It's a really nice play, though, by Naugafin. It's like the best, like, round one, who expects you to just go for the defuse?
But it's Karma, right? He's got the internal clock. He's ready for it. You would hope, but the pressure of a final, maybe.
I don't like the play there from Naugafin. You know, they were set up at middle. There's really not much of a chance. There's two people. Optic are smart enough to realize that if you got to just peek at the bomb every, 6 seconds or so to make sure that doesn't happen. Aqua, though, in this next round, opening with the first blood. Again, the first blood going to Elevate. They need to convert this time.
See if they can get it done. Skump starting to get a little bit aggressive here from AC into steps, but he's got two players to deal with this. He's going to begin to flank through. Now remember, Naugafin has the CUDA and snipe combo. He's going to drop. Let's get back to Skump on the flank. He's already picked up one. It's now only two players left from Elevate. That'd be back-to-back rounds with first bloods that end up falling apart for the Elevate side. Let's look at it from Felony's perspective. He pushes forward. He gets one. Not able to do it. It's all on Facinto now. Can he get it done? 25 seconds. It's the lower wall run trying to wrap around the back. Can he get the surprise? There it is. There's one. He can't pick up the kill, and there's plenty of time for the defuse.
It's a beautiful route, though, by Facinto. Very nice play, just not able to land the shots down. And the big thing for me, the first two rounds, Optic wins them both, but they're getting first blood. You imagine that Elevate, well, you'd like to think Elevate's gonna settle down and finish off these rounds, but the pressure might be mounting and it might be too much.
They're playing the start of these rounds so well, but Optic just answering back. The veteran play from Skump. He was pushed up lab, able to catch one of those players sleeping from Elevate, and then wraps all the way back to the broken wall run. Stacks up with his teammate. They retake the bomb and instantly hop it. Great stuff from Optic, and they're just showing. They're just so strong right now. Elevate taking those first kills, but they can't put them away.
Well, I want to see if maybe Naugafin got an angle off the rip, but you can see with the push here from Optic, they're going to be hitting the B site hard, so that sniper, at least for the time being, going to be taken out of it. Formal saw him in the corner. There's the shot. The one pop is on, and now a first blood for Optic. You got to think they can handle business after how the last several rounds went, but that's Naugafin in the back. You've always got to be wary of this guy when he's got the sniper in his hands.
Yeah, and he knows the HC is going to be hunting for him, and he's going to be able to take it out. Now I'm going to pull the sniper out and see if he can pick up one, open things up for Elevate. It's going to miss a shot, but going to get an eye on one player. He's going to have a teammate go over the top. That's Felony. He actually takes out the player sitting on bomb. Now you're going to see the guys on Elevate start to fly. Two kills in favor of Elevate. Naugafin over the top, not able to take out Karma. Karma needs to stay alive here.
Oh, he's got three. This is for the ace, baby. Can he find the fourth? Maddie, he's got to hunt him down.
I don't think there's enough time for Fellow here. Is sticking on the bomb. Krim's trying to check if he's going to stick the defuse. Fellow able to get it. Can he get the defuse?
He's got it. Yeah. He's got it.
A great play from Fellow. Planted, acted like he was defusing on the bomb. Krim was forced to check. You are unsure in that situation. Fellow, great play from him. Was that the ace as well?
Yes.
That is the ace? with the 1v1 clutch. Felony, big game one, horrific game four, but now stepping it up in the game five where it matters. But the most interesting stat for me from this, the team that has got first blood has lost all three rounds, which is absurd to me.
Yeah, I can't believe it, but Fellow taking, you know, the advantage into his hands. He jumps over, gets that first kill on the bomb, and instantly slides over, challenges the player at side AC. Great plays from Fellow to bring his team back into it. They needed to win that round. I feel like they were going to get 6-0'd unless something happened. That was the play that they needed.
As soon as they find out this B site is open, they got to get bomb down. They got to just push up, or else you see Optic, they take mid-map, and they know that it's open, and then they start to rotate back, get a good setup.
The problem is your planter has the AC up right now, so even if he cleared the site, now he has the opportunity to maybe get down. He got a lot of information. Looks like he wants to get in and stick it. There's the call, but you have Skump coming over the top. He might be able to get an angle on this carrier. Oh, the glitch comes in. Not able to pick it up. Some fancy footwork there coming in from the side of Felony as he keeps going. But they did prevent the plant for now, and there's the first blood. It's Felony. He's got a five streak. Once more, challenging everything. Three players looking at him. Surely he's going to drop. Surely he cannot make this play, but somehow he is still up and getting the plant.
He kind of got his teammate killed there for a second, though, because he jumps out, he blindly challenges, and they feel like they have to back him up. But he earns a lightning and a dart in the process. Karma's going to be able to take him out. See, Nagafin takes Karma out. Krim's going to be able
dead.
To clean up
all
the
dead.
Final two. It's going to be formal. Going to get the defuse, so then we're going to leave it for Krim.
Yep.
Krim's on a three streak, but still, the lightning and dart's a pretty big deal.
What a great pinch setup from Optic there. They left the last player at green while Krim and Karma go around the wall run, sort of catch those players, and that's what Elevate did wrong in that round. That B bomb site, sort of like an island on the map, got themselves trapped. You have to take a side. They didn't do it and are punished.
And I stuck with Felony after the plant because you saw the two players coming from the back for Optic. If that's a one-on-one with the way Felony's been shooting, he probably takes that gunfight. But it wasn't. There were two players there soaring out of mid-connector, soaring out of lab, and he could not take it. Right, honestly, at this point, Matt Felony just needs some damn help.
Yeah, he does. I mean, Naga and Facento combining for 1 and 8 right now. Both of those guys. You see Nagafin, one of the standout players in Search and Destroy. It's really unorthodox for him not play well.
Hard.
And I actually like this call. I actually like the aggressive defensive push from Elevate. I don't think Optic's actually expecting it to be fought back. And you see kills just being traded out. Krim gets back in the lab, and he's going to use an HC.
Oh, it's just Krim. It's just Krim. Can he pick up the kill, though? Trade it out. He doesn't check mid-hut, and like that, he
round.
Is dropped.
It's a good round.
That's a quick round, is what that was.
That's really what you need to do on this map. Middle, so important. It creates those lanes. You can go A or B whenever you get control of it. The fights went down. Skump was able to push through, but shut down by Facento, picking up two.
If I'm Elevate on offense, I hit mid again.
Confidence.
Nagafin has to put the sniper away for these type of pushes to work, and he did there.
Yep.
Who would, like, on Optic side, who would expect him to hit mid two times in a row and challenge you straight up gun on gun? You would.
Especially with how
Fellow's
playing right now.
Yeah.
He's the one open up these maps, but looks like the wall run going in. Looks like they're going to try and open. Nagafin playing it slow. Optic having that B stack right there. Felony hitting the wall run, able to pick up the first streaks are earned by him. Gets traded though. Bomb going down very quickly. I love the decisiveness, but one player, Karma, is stuck at the top AC. He finds one, is patient about it. Will he get gunned though? Karma able to pick up the first, opening the round. Skump able to answer back again. And last player is Aqua, stuck behind.
Well, he's got one. Can he find more? There's a second. A challenge of Aqua trying to pull three. Can't do it. Karma, two rings, clutching up, plenty of time for the defuse. He's 7-3. He's on a two streak. He has the heat wave to work with next round and came up big for his side, 4-2 Optic.
He'll be 50 off an HC as well. So, you know, you've used Crims in the previous round in the 1v2. Nothing happens with it. Maybe you get that one. You can use it to push forward onto the B-bomb site, open it up where Skunk can get bombed down on another offensive round. I think that would probably be a pretty good setup for Optic.
HC's very good to use to scout around the map. You can clear out B-bomb site. You can clear out middle, gain a lot of information. But we have to keep an eye on Felony streaks as well. I feel like this is the player. These are the situations where you need to clutch up with these and guarantee yourself a round to bring this back. This is the round you have to win. You have to use them here because going down 5-2 versus Optic when they have all this momentum is going to be impossible.
What I would do if I was Elevate, I would have Aqua peek out over on the B top of the map and fall back like you're going to give the B side up. As soon as he falls back and gives it up to Optic, kind of like bait them into the plant,
right.
I would call the lightning in.
I like that a lot.
Well, he checked. He didn't use the lightning or the dart, so he still has those to hold on to. But now you'll see it's going to be really Felony here to deal with all the pressure. He has streaks to work with, but you see the X-ray. They're all flying in. He's set up close corner. They both hit the hole. Nope, one flies in. They find him in the corner. There goes the first blood. Yet again, two Optic Gaming. They've got the sight. They should shortly have the plant. And another one down. Two players to deal with. Bomb getting planted. You got Karma mid-map. He's got one on the wall run. Can he find more? The last player is going to be Pacinto. And he tries to stick it. Maybe sneak in a defuse. But that's not working against Optic Gaming there.
Fellow making another mistake on the Elevate side. When you have this streak, when you're the most important player on the map, you can't put yourself in a situation that far up away from your teammates to get picked off. But Optic sniffs him out at the palace, the slide, the first blood, able to take him out. And now, will the streaks from Fellow even be used? The wave is ready. So many things Optic has to clear out and clinch this map.
On offense, you can't play that slow. Like, the defensive side can cover so much of the map and push you so far back that if they wait for these streaks, they may never actually even get up and approach a site.
Well, let's see what the plan is. Yeah, it looks like it may be a rather aggressive defense that comes in, but remember, Felony still has these streaks to work with. I've got him highlighted. It doesn't, okay, here it goes. Dart out. Can he clutch up? What's Flak Jacket looking like for the other side? He's got one. That's at least one kill, trying to find more. There's two. The streak's coming up big. He's hunting one on the lower wall run. I'm coming for you, buddy. Chasing him all the way mid-map. You know, don't you dare cut that through. Hot, wrap it around the back. I'm behind. He's coming. There he
is.
Just get him. Get him. Get him. Oh, able to connect. And now as Felony comes out, it's a 1v1. Four elevates, hopes, and dreams. No, I'm sorry, Facento's still up, so I actually have two to work with. It's all on Karma.
Karma working up towards bomb. Now stuck in this 1v2. Will the two rings be able to clutch? This is going to do it for Optic if he's able to do it. But no, Facento had a good setup there on the porta potties, and they're staying alive here.
That was going to get really dangerous. If he wins that first gunfight against Felony, he knows he's going to get shot from the side here. He pops his heat wave. This guy's dead. It's a big play there.
Well, Pacinto is the guy earlier that picked up the kill with the RK5 through the heat wave. Remember, he's some sort of magician. Maybe he gets it done again.
Doing it again.
I wouldn't either. But, all right, here we go. Optic Gaming on offense. Can they get it done here, or are we going to push this to a round 10? Let's take a look at the minimap as the offensive push. Uh-oh. They're going low around the back. Are they going to be able to surprise anybody? Oh. You have a pretty passive defense for the side of Elevate.
Well, Elevate's playing around these streaks again. That's their whole game plan, but they have no idea where Karma has snuck behind. He's actually able to draw first blood, taking out Nagafan, but it's going to be Felony answering back. He's going to earn himself glitch as well, but they have to get Karma out from behind. The bomb down at A, he's in a very advantageous position to make a big play.
Well, here comes the break. This could be everything for the side of Elevate. You got one in the corner. Can't win the gunfight. That's Scumpy winning it. Karma might be coming on the flank. Let's get back to Pacinto. Is he able to trade the kill? He cannot. Camo comes around the back. He's off the map. It's all on Aqua. Do or die. The heat wave in. There's one. Where's Formal? He's behind. Can't locate. There's so little time to work with. He sees him in the corner. He's got to push him. He has to make a play. Formal trying to stay away, and that should be it. He's got around the back. There's not enough time to work with, and Optic Gaming has done it.
A tremendous play by Formal there just to stay alive, waits just enough, checks the bomb, throws a nade on it, and then he's able to pick up the kill at the end.
Wow, what incredible stuff. You see the team. Yeah, I thought it was Campbell coming across. He bumps him off the map. See you later, buddy. Pacinto getting tossed. We'll wait for the guys to begin to claim their trophy here. And there you have it. You see Scott moving forward. Optic Gaming are your 2016 MLG Anaheim Open Champions.